Hi guys, this is Adam Gussow from Satan and Adam, and I'm coming back at you with a second lesson on train songs. And so what I'm doing, I'm using an A harp, a marine band. And by the way, for all of you who write in asking me what kind of harmonica should you get, it's hard for me to say. I've only really ever used Hohner marine bands. So occasionally I've tried special 20s, and I've used a Golden Melody every now and then. Basically, I'm a Hohner marine band guy. Every seventh marine band is no good. Every seventh one is unbelievably good, and the middle five are really pretty darn good. So, and nobody is paying me to say that. It's just what I do. It's just what I use. So, okay. So I've got an A harp. The low harps are the ones that are best for train songs, I think, because you can get that chucka chucka sound on the low reeds. Let's sort of back off and let's recapitulate the lesson that I just gave you. The key thing here is, rather than subtlety of technique, you need pretty aggressive technique. Rather than always having a free flow of air through the harp, well, of course you want to flow, but you're trying to interrupt it by getting very staccato. Tuck, tuck, tuck. And so the basic move is that tuck, tuck, or knuck, knuck, chuck, chuck rhythm of your tongue hitting your roof of your mouth and then releasing. K-ka, chuk-ka, tuk-ka, tuk-ka, right? Tuk-ka. Okay, that's the back of your tongue. It's like tuk-ka. Okay? So I'm going to go. And so that's the way you'd start it. I'm going tuk-ka. On the in-breath, same thing on the out-breath. And then you simply start with the nukka on the in-breath as your downbeat. And you want to do nukka tukka, nukka tuk. That's one beat. Nukka tukka, nukka tukka. Can you hear my beat? Thump, 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 thump. Now, once you've gotten that, okay, there's a few things you want to begin to play with. Now, one of them is, how fast do you do it, right? So you want to play around with slowing it down and as you do that, you may notice that a little more air is flowing through the harp, and what you want to do is let your upper lip float away from the harp. Remember this technique from way back from our rainy day sojourns, 6 weeks ago. You're allowed to use the word sojourns, by the way, as a blues harmonica player. For years, I didn't think so, but trust me, you're allowed to. I'm going to give you a little one more word lesson. Do you know what the word pulchritude means? It's one of those unusual words that actually sounds like exactly the opposite of what it is. Pulchritude means female beauty. Sort of a W.C. Fields kind of word, right? Pulchritude, pulchritude means beautiful. Ma'am, I admire your pulchritude, right? And before she slaps you, explain what you meant. You were complimenting her. Okay. So when you get it fast, you're going. You see, these harp players were like the beatbox guys of their own time. And this is not even my style of harp. That's in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. And the faster you can do it without the harp, the faster you can do it with the harp. Now, at a certain point, you'll get mush mouth. The whole thing will fall apart. For those of you who are just learning this, it's going to happen all the time at the beginning. So what I would do, my theory about, and this is important, my theory about how to speed up things that you're learning how to play is always start slow, start medium slow, start so there's no question of your ability to handle the technical requirement of the speed per se. And then in the course of your practicing, it's okay bit by bit to increase the speed. Then push it to the point where it collapses, where you can't do it. And then back off a little bit and never go above that for a practice session until the very end, when you can, runners say you're running for the barn, you can kind of push it on off, okay? especially if you haven't practiced for a while, you're not going to have full speed. So don't always be trying to do full speed, right? You want to back off a little below that so you're within your technical capacity. Now, the second thing, of course, is to open and close the cup. Remember I gave you that lesson, I talked about how I'm going to hold it, right? Remember that? Okay. So, you have a choice. You can open it when you're going in. Actually, now I'm opening it every second time. Or you can slowly open it, and this is what the old time guys used to do, as though the train's going through a tunnel. I'm not really a train song player. Okay. Now, the third thing is, of course, any train song player on harmonica worth his salt is going to know how to make the whistle. What's the whistle? Okay. Well, you start with the 3/4 hole double stop. And before you do anything to it, make sure that it's nice and loud and clear. And then you want to put a scoop on it, right? You want to come into it from a little bit below. You want to put some bending energy on that 3/4 double stop. And I find that what I want to do, I want to go wee. That's what my tongue is doing. I'm going woo, woo. The woo is the bend, the little scoop. And then you want to thin out the sound and let it get really reedy. And to do that, you push your tongue forward in your mouth. Watch this. That's the opposite of the deep blues sound, right? And so I think it's important here to understand. When you want the deep blues sound, right, I told you to take your tongue way back in your mouth. Drop your jaw. Make a big resonating chamber to thin out the sound. And especially this is important if you're going quickly on a train rhythm. You want your tongue forward. So you can go way, way. When I do this in class, sometimes I have people pull down their hands to, that's like the steam. Right? Okay. And there's lots of other things you can do. This lesson is, it's heading towards a close. I think that what we're going to do is I'm going to just play a little bit, give you a sense of what I might do with this. I'll come back at you with one more lesson on train songs, a different kind of rhythm, a slightly easier rhythm than this one. One more thing. Here I'm remembering. One way of throwing a slight variation on this train thing is to sort of shift the focus of your mouth's attention. Does that make any sense? From the two hole to the one hole. Tucka 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 tucka. Now you're still doing the 1-2-3 hole on pretty much both of those, but you're kind of shifting the center of gravity a little bit, and it gives you a nice, God, it's hot in here, gives you a nice, if I do it slowly, you'll hear it. Now, you know, you may not believe this, but there are certain states of people who do a breathing meditation, mindfulness meditation, we'll talk about the sort of higher states of consciousness. There are some there's at least two or three higher states of consciousness that are connected with doing train rhythms. And if you don't believe me, do them long enough, find the magic groove where you're well within your technical capacity. The closest analog that I can think of is as a runner finding my point just below my maximal aerobic a sustainable, just below the lactate threshold, when you can just cruise. You're running a marathon, say, or half marathon, you're just cruising down the road, and your breathing is steady state. So what you want to find is that kind of maximum steady state. Back off from it a little bit, relax, look around, step inside the beat. This is what Ralph Ellison was talking about in Invisible Man, when the Invisible Man takes a hit off a joint. I don't encourage you to do that, but I'm just saying this is what he does. And then he listens to a Louis Armstrong solo. What did I do to be so black and blue? And suddenly he finds himself descending down through the music, almost into history, and down all of a sudden to some great grandmother slave woman who talks about sleeping with the master. And it's like a descent into history, as though the music has all these different levels. Well, and one of the levels is to sink into history. Another level in this music is to just kind of sink into a slightly different place of awareness. you'll find this happening. You'll find yourself not sure what's the downbeat and what's the upbeat. That's a very good thing, little cricket. It's a very good sign. This lesson's over. I'm over time. I've got to run. Thank you so much for spending time with me. Remember, if you want more advanced lessons and more beginning lessons, you can go to my website, modernbluesharmonica.com. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.